Hey guys, so welcome to my channel. So today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to get these white zicker bows. Starting off with these crusty booty diggers. So I'm just going to be showing you the process of how I take off the old gel nail polish that I had. I start off by just using some random acetone and some little nail cups to soak off the gel nail polish. So I'll be starting doing that. And yes, so now I'm about to get ready to take those off and use a scraper tool to scrape that off. And from what you're about to see, I didn't leave it on long enough, so it was pointless to really use this tool, but I was being extra regardless. But yeah, I'm just showing you me trying to scrape it off. Oh, so now I'm about to use my nail bit drill. I'm about to do what these people do in the nail shops and file that John off. So yeah, I'm just showing you the process and what bit I use. So then I just start filing it off. And this is really going to take off the nail. Not the nail, but like the gel. So, just watch that, y'all. So, now I'm about to get ready to start filing my nail. And basically, what I'm showing you is just, this is, like, the beginning of how I prep my nails. If I was able to do gel, I would still follow this same routine. Like, if I was just going to do gel nails instead of acrylic. Just, like, filing them and giving them a nice, like, square shape. But yeah, that's what I'm doing now. And then, instead of like using I just use a scissors to like clip my nails. Yeah, nail clipper. I use a scissors to clip my nails. And then just getting rid of that dead skin, the cuticles. You really want to make sure your cuticles are pushed back and clean, because that's going to really prevent the nail from lifting up. But yeah, make sure you get all up in there or whatever and get that really good. But I'm just gonna let y'all watch me clip and get those cuticles in check. Fingers looking not crusty anymore. So right now I just showed you me getting my acrylics ready and just trimming them down. Y'all, I promise you I know what I'm talking about, even though it doesn't sound like I know what I'm talking about. This is just my first video, okay? So bear with me. So anyways, I'm just filing those. You want to make sure that you take the shine away from the acrylic nail and just really rough it up so that the gel or whatever method you're using, acrylic or hard gel, it sticks on better to that nail. So yeah, I'm using the IBD hard gel in pink or whatever. I really like this stuff. My nail lady, she used it on me before all this quarantine. But yeah, I'm just going to show you how I do this. So taking that gel brush, I start off from the base. So you really want to pack on the base so that the cuticle is like covered completely. But then you want to like thin it out. But you just want to make sure that cuticle is packed at the beginning when you first start, because this gel, it's gonna balance itself out. If you do use this, you know what I'm talking about. But yeah, I just basically start shaping the nail. This stuff is really sticky too. But it works really good. Like, I like this better than acrylic, honestly. But yeah, I'm showing you again. I start off with a thick layer of it at the base of the nail, the cuticle area, and then I thin it out towards the tip. But yeah, you just want to start packing it for the base and then have it thick in the middle, that bridge, and then just start thinning it out at the tip. And what I'm doing, skip just forming it and just getting it in the shape, so that when you do cure, I cure for 90 seconds. When you do cure, that it's in that shape, because this stuff, it does take a minute for it to cure, and it is very sticky. So yeah, I'm just gonna continue doing that in this and just speed up some clips and let you guys watch so that you're able to see for yourself how to do it. Again, just packing on at the base, like I said previously. It's really packing on the cuticle, and then once you start doing that and it's formed, you want to start bringing it up to the tip and just really have the nail like fully balanced out. But like I said, you really want to pack on that cuticle, and I mean, I wouldn't say make it too thick, but you just want the cuticle fully covered so you don't have to worry about any lifting. So then right here, I'm using the Sun SUV machine. I ordered that off Amazon, whatever. But I use the 90 seconds. And after I finish curing them for like 90 seconds, I then go ahead and use the alcohol to remove that stickiness, like I said. So it's not sticky anymore. So it's like a film. But now I'm going to go ahead and show you guys using that same nail bit that I used in the beginning. I'm going to start shaping the nail and get it to my liking. So right now I've been liking like that, not so much coffin, but like the stiletto with a hint of coffin shape. You know, you've seen Kylie Jenner probably rocking those nails. But yeah, I'm basically just showing you how I filed the nail and bring it down, and really just get it to my liking. So I'm just gonna let you guys watch that. One thing I will say is that I love long nails, and I be hating. One thing that irks me is I hate when I'm at work or whatever, and people be like, "Oh, your nails are so long. How do you even function with them?" Like, sis, I function perfectly fine. Mind your business. But yeah, get back to the video, y'all. So here's the finished product of the nails after being washed and cleaned. So I'll be taking my base coat first. I know it kind of moves kind of fast, but I take the base coat, cure that, then I take my white gel nail polish and do two coats of that, and then cure in between for 30 seconds or so. And then after I finish doing the two coats, I will put on a top coat, which you see right there, and then cure that for 90 seconds. And that's the final product. What cute long white zinc grippers. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching my first video. I hope you guys enjoyed. See you on the next one.